Tulsa was a good example of just what happens when hate festers for so long. You're talking about 35 blocks of a community gone in less than 24 hours. It was a vibrant, bustling community before the massacre. What made Black Wall Street was segregation. So by continually pumping their own money in their communities, they grew their community. And there were a lot of white people who did not like that. Most of the experts I've spoken to have a consensus that there was a man, his name was Dick Rowland. He was accused of assaulting a 17-year-old white woman in an elevator. For whatever reason, at some point, the elevator jerked and he leaned or fell forward into this girl who then screamed. The next thing you know, there are rumors that he assaulted Sarah Page. He was arrested and he was held in the jail in Tulsa. Most of the Black people in Tulsa were oblivious to what was going on for a while, except word of a lynch mob forming got back to them. At some point, a scuffle broke out between a white man and a Black man. A shot was fired. We don't know who exactly fired that shot, but that essentially is how the Tulsa Race Massacre started. There were thousands of white people who wanted to either lynch somebody or wanted to cause harm and destruction to Black people. There were theaters, there were hospitals, there were schools, there were convenience stores. So this was a community like any other, but it was also exceptional for the amount of money that was flowing in and out of it for that time, especially because it was a predominantly Black community. There were people who lived in Tulsa, white and Black, for decades who had never heard of the Tulsa Race Massacre. And that is because after the massacre, there were deliberate efforts made to suppress the story.
Juneteenth is a day where African Americans celebrate the liberation from chattel slavery here in America. And we celebrate and we have a wonderful time. We were very disgusted by him choosing the day of Juneteenth. We felt it was very tone deaf and a blatant disregard for African American history. I commend him for changing the date. I commend him for listening to his African American friends, but I encourage him to listen to all African Americans, especially those of us who have been protesting in the streets.
What do we want?
Peace!
When do we want it?
Now!
We are peace! We are peace!
All lives can't matter until Black lives matter. Because we're all, the color of our skin should never define anyone. We're people.
There's a lot of awareness and attention being paid to the Black experience in America. And the Tulsa Race Massacre is an example of what the Black experience in America was like in 1921. The more people who know about this, the more awareness there is that this happened in this country, and the more incentive there is to make sure that it never happens again.